Hi, and welcome to another edition of Friendly Plastic TV. I'm your host, Linda Peterson of Linda Peterson Designs. And on today's episode, I've taken Friendly Plastic TV on the road all the way to Denver, Colorado, to the home and studio of my friend, Jen Lowe of Jen Lowe Designs. So we thought we'd share with you a little bit of eye candy. But first, we need to go meet Jen. Are you ready to go meet her? Let's go. My friend Jen Lowe of Jen Lowe Designs, and she has been so gracious to invite me here for an entire week in the studio. And you're going to say,
what studio?
I know, because we want to show you this mess. This is what happens when you give two creative people free reign in an art studio. This used to be Jen's formal living room and her dining room. Isn't this just a riot? But now we know you want to see some eye candy, so let's get on and show you some eye candy. These are a couple of the pieces that we've worked with using the die cut techniques. One is a pendant that Jen has made. We were kind of in a butterfly mood this week. Looks like you have quite a bit of mixed media on this pendant here.
Well, once again, I took the pellets and melted them out and rolled them out flat. And then I die cut this with the Spellbinders butterfly die. And I was able to emboss it. And I did not heat it. This is totally cold plastic that I've die cut and embossed here. Once I was done, I used a bladder pin with blending solution in it and picked up alcohol ink and applied my color. I put a layer of glossy accents on top of that, let it dry, and then guess what I set the rhinestones with?
I have no idea. I don't even think I was watching you when you were doing this.
I used a hot fix applicator by Creative Crystals, and I used a rheostat. So if you have just a hot fix applicator, it's going to be way too hot and it'll melt the plastic. Mm-hmm. But you set the rheostat on 40 and your hot fix applicator doesn't get that hot, yet it will melt the glue on the back of the crystal and you can set it right into the plastic. It's wonderful.
That's very clever. And it's true that you can feel a texture on the top of this. I know you can see it, but you can feel the texture. And I think that's what is so interesting about this is that we're getting the pellets to die cut, to texture, and to do a lot of things with paper craft. So it's going to really be something of interest to rubber stampers and people that work with paper.
I can use my stamps and all my paper crafting tools on it. It's great.
And one other thing, tell me about this. How'd you get the little antennas there?
What's
that made of?
That's just simply wire that I flattened with a hammer.
Okay, very good. And then you finished the back with?
I just die cut and embossed in black glossy cardstock and taped it on the back.
Okay, very good. This is one that I did. Again, I don't know why we're in such a butterfly mood. I used alcohol inks. I used a little bit different method. I just simply melted pellets onto the griddle and then I applied the alcohol inks. That was actually set into the background. You can see that this is a pre-purchased metal pendant that I've got here. This little butterfly is a little die cut, and like Jen, except for hammering, I added the little wire accents to this piece here. Now we've got a couple of other pieces that we'll show you here real quick. Here's another little die cut butterfly. This was just pellets, alcohol ink, a little bit of glitter, and a little glossy accents to give that a little bit of bling. And then this one I think I'm going to put onto a card. I really like this. This is kind of multimedia die cut. I've got a metal frame that I've had for a long time, and then I used some of Amoco's wire mesh. You can see I've attached it with some glue dots on the background. So again, multimedia. And these are some of the projects that we've done with die cuts. Okay, Jen, I think this is a mask that you made using, is this Crafty Ladies Mold?
Crafty Ladies Mold, designed by my sister Colleen Lee.
Very nice, very nice. And a lot of people in the UK are using mold, so this really isn't something new. It's kind of new to us because we're working with pellets, and the pellets are really taking off. Now, did you use the rheostat here to set this little bling in here?
For those, I just simply use glossy accents and put them on top. But I like how each one of those little flowers and leaves is from a different piece of Friendly Plastic strips, and I just simply cut the strips a little bit bigger than the size of the mold and pressed them down into the mold, and they just came out perfect.
This is really pretty. Outline stickers are real popular now. You can get them in a variety of different shapes and colors. I've showed you here just what some of the outline stickers that we've used for our project. These are from Amoco. We have a selection of flowers and swirls and die cuts and things like that. Also, Jen put out here a wooden bangle bracelet, and she used outline stickers to accent this bangle bracelet?
Oh, I simply took a strip and a half of the frilly plastic and melted it on the griddle, heated it up, and then just shaped it around the bangle bracelet, trimmed the edges off. An electric hot knife worked perfect for trimming the edges off of the plastic on the bracelet here. And then I applied the outline stickers to the top, and I used alcohol ink to apply color. And once again, I used my heat set crystals applicator to put the crystals in the center of the flowers.
Okay, and if I remember right in watching you do this, I know that this bangle's been covered with friendly plastic, and we weren't real happy with the color. It was a red and silvery color. It was just kind of okay, right? And you rescued it.
Oh, you're just going to rat out all my secrets.
I'm
sorry. Of course
sorry.
I did. I just applied a layer of cranberry alcohol ink to the top of it, okay. And it was perfect.
Very good. And again, she used the hot knife to trim out all around this little edge here, which I think is just a wonderful technique. Now, let me show you a few things that I did. A little bit, I don't know, maybe simpler, I'm not sure. Now, you know, from my polymer clay experience, I love to come up with faux stones. That's kind of one of my favorite things to do, is come up with different recipes and things. Simply, these are pellets that I have mixed in a variety of different things, from alcohol inks to distress embossing powders. And with those two things, you get a lot of different effects. And this one here looks kind of like a jade. It's real pretty. And then I simply just highlighted these with outline stickers. This one here, I actually painted a little bit of alcohol inks to color the outline stickers and give it a little bit more embellishment. Now again, working with my polymer clay experience and the fact that I love organic, I love stone effects, this was just kind of a couple of things that I stumbled on. First of all, I love turquoise, and I've been pretty successful recreating turquoise in polymer clay, and I thought, what if I do it in friendly plastic?
And I didn't think she could do it.
She didn't think I could do it. I won't share the tip or technique because it does need to be refined, but this is proof right here. That is friendly plastic. It is not polymer clay, and that is very similar to my turquoise technique that I do in polymer clay. Now also, this was kind of a fluke, but I really loved the way it turned out. I had some green plastic just sitting in. I use the hot water method for the majority of the things that I do. In fact, Jen and I use the hot water method, I would say probably 75% of the time this week.
At least, yeah.
Between that and the griddle method. Now, I had some green clay, and I had mixed it with some distress inks, and I gotta say, I really didn't like the pattern. I just kind of threw it in the hot water and let it set, and this set for hours. When I pulled it out, I don't know if you can tell, but there's all kinds of little bubbles here. And I thought, wow, that really looks like coral. And I thought, there's some great things that can be made with that. And I haven't done anything with it yet, but yeah, just let your pellets sit in water. If you don't like the color or you don't like the way the swirl turned out, stick it in the pellets and see what you get. Then I did the same thing. I wasn't real crazy about the color that I mixed up here, but I thought, why don't we put some fantasy film over the top of it? And I heated it with a heat gun, and of course, heating it with a heat gun causes a different surface effect. It causes the plastic to kind of bubble up.
Can you move that one on the side so they can see the texture? Because
yeah,
it's just
the texture
amazing.
It's hard to see, really.
But it's got
maybe
some
I can
great
pull it up.
Depth.
It does. I'll try to take a picture of this and put it at the end of the video so you can see up close and personal. But really, the fantasy film split, when you look at this in person, it really does look like the inside of a shell.
It does. It looks, what's the word, abalone?
Abalone,
yeah.
So, you know, sometimes you have happy mistakes. Aside from my turquoise, these three here were some happy mistakes. Well, that'll do it for another episode of Friendly Plastic TV. I hope you've enjoyed all the techniques and the things that we've done this week to show you. We've certainly enjoyed sharing it with you. And I want to thank my friend Jen for having me. I've just had an incredible time. And I have to thank Carrie, too, because that's Jen's husband. He put up with us for 9 days. And
he's a sweetie.
He is a sweetie. So thank you, Carrie. Thank you, Jen, for the incredible experience.
Oh, thank you for coming. I've just had a blast.
Next time,
so much fun.
Next time you come to my studio.
Okay.
Now be sure and check us out on our blog at friendlyplastic.blogspot.com and on the Amoco website at www.amoco.com. And that'll do it for this episode of Friendly Plastic TV.